Can you be here?
Good afternoon, everybody.
Watch out.
We are here today on a sad day. It's a real sad day. We're going to cut the lights off and watch the videos. And this is Chance's day.
Amen.
You know, we're going to miss Chance.
In this guy.
I love Chance. Everybody loves Chance Partain. Everybody loves Chance Partain.
Amen.
I'm trying to. I've talked to him several occasions, and he was a great guy. He was a great guy. Everybody loved Chance. We're gonna get on into a message here. I'm gonna preach to you a little bit today about a few things because I think some people here need to hear some stuff. But we're gonna, Doug, get the lights in the back. Somebody get these and let's watch these videos.
Did you start it over?
What?
Bye.
same song.
Oh, we want the same song. Same song. She wants the same song.
I started her. If this video still hasn't completed, then do the I'll Be Missing You.
Then I'll Be Missing You.
And then
we have to take it from the rest of the rest. Yeah. You just want to replay the video.
No, but the video can just get there, stop. Just want it complete and stop it.
Keep playing the videos after the music, just keep it cutting out. I'm gonna go with it. They said make it show what Penny's about to pass out. After this song, we're gonna go with it.
So stop the music after this song finishes.
And just keep the videos.
Stop the music after the song.
And yeah. Keep the videos
keep
playing.
The video playing.
Keep the video
playing. Yes.
Funeral. This is a bad situation the way this thing happened. We all love Chance. There's a couple of people that's wanting to speak. They asked me to put this together. Hey, Bob. Asked me to put this together. I just done the best I could with it, and I really tried to do a great job because he meant a lot to me. He really did. Him and my son was friends, and he, every time I see him, I pray with him, and he meant a lot to me. He meant a lot to all of us, and but I'm gonna tell you something. The lives that I lived when I was out there in the streets, I don't know how I made it, and it's good to know Jesus. He knows Jesus, He knows Jesus. I know he knows Jesus. Because every time he'd come down here some days and he'd say, man, I'm having a bad day. Would you pray for me? And I would pray for him. And he knew that if he needed prayer, he would come ask me. You know, I deal with a lot of rough people. I ain't saying he was rough, but I do. And a lot of people won't go to Sam Duncan or First Baptist or some places. They want to come down here because I've been where they've been. I didn't learn this in no book. I've learned it from hands-on. And I got saved July the 1st, 2008. God changed my life. And now I help people with hurts, habits, and hang-ups and addictions. And Chance was a great guy. I'm going to tell you, before we go into Scripture, a lot of people say, well, if you don't go to church, you don't make it to heaven. That's a lie. That is a lie. Because when Jesus was hanging on the cross, there was two thieves hanging beside him. One of them says, if you the king, get your angels to come down and take us down. And the other one said, Lord, will you remember me in your paradise? And that guy was never in church, and he's saved, and he's in heaven today. So we don't know what happened at the final moments of Chance's life. I know Chance knows the Lord, and I believe once saved, always saved. I believe you can drift off. God never leaves you. I believe that if you ever get saved, you always say, listen, God never turns his back on nobody. He never turns his back on you. Sometimes we walk off from him and leave him. We forget about him. Things get good. But you need Jesus in your life today. We all need Jesus. I want to read you a scripture. Ecclesiastes 3. There is a time for everything, a season for everything under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die. Listen to me. We all got death coming our way. Our day is numbered. It's coming. You might as well face it. Ain't nothing you can do about it to stop it. It's going to happen. Are you ready? Are you ready? Now, I'm not saying something can't happen. You have a car wreck and you get saved and you go to heaven. That can't happen. But it sure is good living a Christian life. There's nothing better than serving God. Since I got saved, I was 45 years old, and I used to run the streets, man. I run them hard. And I'm not proud of none of that. And I thought God would never have me for some of the stuff I've done. But he did, and he saved me. Started me off down here to church cleaning toilets and doing this and doing that. Now I'm senior pastor of this church. And I love to see people get saved and change their life through the love of Jesus Christ. Because without him, we can't do nothing. There's a time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant, a time to harvest. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to rebuild. Penny, you got to rebuild now. Chance, you'll see Chance again one day. I know you haven't known. Hard time with this. I knowed it. When I heard it, I said, oh my God, first thing I said, old Penny. But Penny, listen to me. I want you to be tough. And I want you to live through this. I want you to be happy. I want the family to be happy. Because Chance wouldn't want you miserable, none of you. And look, a lot of your best friends with him sitting here. This should change your life. This should do, hey, listen, this tragedy, sometimes bad things cause good things. A time to cry and a time to laugh. This is a sad day. But if he's done entered the kingdom of heaven, we should be rejoicing because there's no more pain, no more suffering, no more police, no more nothing. No more devil. It's serious, y'all. Jesus Christ is the Lord and Savior. And without him, life ain't gonna never amount to nothing. My way never got me nothing but jail. Stayed in jail all the time. And I'm not bragging on account of this. I'm just telling the way life is. But if we can learn to have a one-on-one personal relationship with God, things are so much better. I'm telling you. There's a time to grieve and a time to dance. People's grieving right now when we should be dancing because he's in heaven. A time to embrace and a time to turn away. A time to search and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear down, a time to mend. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. Chance had a life, a good life. Penny was a good mother to him. I've been knowing him since he was a little boy, lived in the apartment, a little blonde-headed boy running around. He had a good life. He made some bad decisions, yeah, he did. But you stay, if anybody in here hadn't made some, I want you to raise your hand because I want to come check it. We've all made some stupid mistakes in our life. And we all get tied up in the world and think we're doing something when we really ain't doing nothing. But I want you to know, Chance, I really just feel I got a piece of my heart about this. That under the situation, way this thing happened, don't look real good. But the world ain't no good either, you know what I mean? The world ain't no good. The devil, John 10:10 says, the devil comes to kill, steal, destroy. But the Lord says, I've come to give you life and give you life more abundantly.
Amen.
And I got a couple people wanting to have to come up and say a couple words. Do y'all mind, family?
All right, everybody. I'm Cody Keaton, for those of you that don't know me. I just wanted to start off to thank everybody for coming out. Pay your respects to Chance and Penny, his family. Penny, I offer you my deepest sympathies. I'm sorry for your loss. Everybody, we all love Chance. We all lost a good friend today. And it's a day for mourning, but we also need to rejoice the life that he lived. Be thankful for the memory that we had with him.
Come on, Carly.
Give him strength, Lord.
Sorry, y'all.
Come on, Cody.
I met Chance when I was 12, 13 years old. Still a mutual friend. And we just befriended each other. And even though I hadn't seen him in 3 years or so, if he walked through this door right now, we'd pick up where we left off. It was just that kind of friendship. If I could use 3 words to describe Chance, that would be smart, funny, and like we all know, hungry. Always hungry. He always had a big smile on his face. And on your worst day, his goofy words, ideas can make anybody smile or anybody laugh. That was just Chance. That smile is, when I think of him, that's what I see. It's just Chance with that big smile. He always looked out for his friends. He made sure he wasn't hungry, wasn't thirsty. I'm pretty sure one summer that we had to run up $1 million worth of tab. It had to at least be that much. But we shared a lot of memories, some good, some bad, as all true friendships do. But we always came back around and found each other back as friends. Everybody just remember, life is short. You never know what's going to happen from today to the next. Death is promised. And we never know when it's going to come calling. So when you walk out this any door from your family, let them know you love them. You know, take your life and make something positive out of it. And get away from the devil. I know I've been a victim of addiction, that lifestyle, and you never know when your time might come. Thank y'all. Chance, fly high. We love you, brother.
Amen, Cody.
Has anybody else got anything they'd like to say about Chance? This is his day. If you're his friends and you got something to say, don't be shy. Because we down here giving our, you want to? Come on.
Read Chance's favorite Bible verse. As many of y'all know, and I know that this makes a lot of your legs, that's why I put it. Isaiah 54:17 says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue which rises against you in judgment you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. And the righteousness is from me, says the Lord.
Is anybody else? You know, while we're here today, I want to go over just a few things, basic things of life. We got a devil on this side, and we got God over here. And we got to make up our mind who we're going to serve. You can't serve you can't serve the devil, and you can't serve God. You got a choice. In your life, who you gonna serve? I want to ask everybody in here a question. Because death's coming your way. If you die today, where are you going? If you got killed when you left here today, where are you going? You know, for 32 years, I got robbed. My life by the devil. Out here thought I was something doing this. Married into a family that had all the stuff, and I thought I was a man. Really? I wasn't nothing. I'm here to tell you today about a Lord and Savior named Jesus Christ, who I serve, who Chance served, who a lot of us serve, but we don't give him 100% of our life. And we need Jesus to make it. We need him. Without him, what we gonna do? We're gonna have eternal punishment. burning in hell. And I just want to throw this out here to everybody today, because let me tell you something. Your life means something to me, because I got saved and God put this in my heart. Men that nobody else wants to fool with, don't fool with them, they in jail. No, I'm going to go get them. I'm going after them, because Jesus put that in my heart. I had a man prophesy over me when I was first got saved. He says, "Vernon, you're going to deal with men nobody else wants to deal with, and women. And it's going to be hard, but you're going to do it because God's going to give you that." And I thought, "Man, what are you talking about?" But I do it today. I do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. Because that's what my calling in life is. That's what this church is. This church is for people with hurts, habits, and hang-ups. It's for people to come in. It don't matter what you wear when you come in here. It don't matter what's on the outside of your body. Because all that matters is what's in your heart. And I believe Chance had it in his heart. He did. He made some bad choices. Hey, I made some bad choices. I've been saved 9 years. I still do sometimes. I let my temper fly off on me. I do things I know I shouldn't do, but it bothers me. But he would get so bad sometimes that he would pull up out there in the car and say, "Vernon, I need you to pray with me." And that meant something to me. That told me something. You know? Because if you do things and it don't convict your heart, you ain't nowhere. The devil just got you all wrapped up. But if a man will drive down here in a car and pull up and say, "Vernon, I need for you to pray for me. I've been doing some bad things." That told me something. That told me you know the Lord. And I believe it. But if you here today and you don't know God, if you here today and you've met God and you've walked away from Him, it's time to make it right. It's time to make it right. Because I'm telling you, you look at the news today. You look at all that's going on today. It's a jungle right here in Holman Park. I mean, it is awful. This world is wicked. And it's going to get worse. Without Jesus, you ain't going to make it. I want to know, Penny, it's an honor for you to allow me to do this. Chance didn't like to eat. They called me up. My son and him was out there. "Bring us a bucket of chicken and 15 double cheeseburgers." I said, "What?" But I love him. I love him. I'm going to miss him. We're all going to miss him. But listen to me. There's going to be another day when you'll get to see him again. Because I believe in my heart, I don't know what God does. I don't know. God is the Lord. But from what I know of Him and what He's done, and I know we know Jesus. And let me tell you something. If you could get saved and be perfect, Jesus Christ wouldn't have to die on the cross for you. But the things that we can't handle, people don't understand addiction. It's a wicked thing, dude. It's hard. You got to have a lot of love. You got to have a lot of Jesus to get over something like that. The things that we can't handle is what He died on the cross and bought and paid for us with the blood. The blood of Jesus will set you free. It'll break every chain of bondages in your life. I want to thank y'all for listening to me. I didn't come up here to do a sermon. I come up here for a chance today. I wouldn't have missed this for the world. I loved him, man. We was friends. I was older than him, but he kind of looked up to me a little bit. You know, he'd come and, let me pray for him. And I thought, wow, man, this is pretty cool, you know. So let's just remember the good things in his life. Penny, family, y'all don't let this tear y'all down. please, I know it's hard, but time heals everything. And just keep your remember, keep your pictures, keep your family together, y'all get closer. And if there's anything that laborers of the field can do for you, we're just a phone call away. Matter of fact, I'm gonna cook you some food and send it down there to you. You staying in the trailer? I'm gonna have you some food cooked and send it to you this week, okay? And I want you to know, if you don't have a home church, you don't feel like, if you go to a church and they too uppity for you, you walk through these doors, what you see is what you get. Just a bunch of old country boys that believe in Jesus. Bunch of old rednecks that got saved and give their life to the Lord. I'm gonna tell you something, God is so good. We're gonna close out in prayer, okay? Father God, we come to you today, Lord, with a humble heart. Lord, I pray for each and every person that's in this room. Lord, I pray that you'll comfort them. Lord, I pray for Penny especially. Lord, I love her. She's such a good person. Her daughter, I don't know, but I pray for her. I pray that you'll give them wisdom, strength, courage to handle this situation, Lord. And Lord, most of all, I pray that they'll have a one-on-one personal relationship with you. And that goes for everybody in the church. I pray that they'll come closer to you on account of this situation. I pray that you'll manifest in each and everybody's life. And Lord, if they're not saved, I pray that they can't sleep at night until they cry out, Jesus, please help me. And Father, we love you today. We'll give you the honor, the praise, the glory. And Lord, we thank you for the life that you give Chance. And Lord, we just love you today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
We got a couple more songs if anybody would. Hold on just a minute.
saving Amy. Saving Amy. And then, who is Kyle? It's the next one over.
Amy's got the mother's eye.
the one that's playing now is saying me. Yeah. Oh, the next song anyway is the next one. Oh.